You're eating out at a restaurant with friends and you start to feel a tickle in your throat. You look down at your hands and you realize that they're covered in hives. That tickle in your throat turns into a tightness and you realize that you're starting to have trouble breathing. Something isn't right. Your throat is closing up. Your friends ask if you're okay. They say, "You don't look so good." You suddenly realize that the pasta you ate may have been contaminated with shellfish, to which you are deathly allergic. This isn't just an allergic reaction. This is the most serious and life-threatening type of allergic reaction, and it's called anaphylaxis. What do you do if you develop anaphylaxis, and what happens once you reach the emergency department? I'm going to answer those questions for you. And by the end of this video, you'll know what to do if you ever find yourself in this situation. Regardless of where you are, eating out at a restaurant, watching a baseball game, or getting it on with a latex condom, the first thing you need to do is call for emergency medical help. If you're in the United States, this means calling 911. If you're around other people, ask someone close by to do this for you. If you're alone, unfortunately, you will need to make the call yourself. If you develop anaphylaxis, you need to be evaluated at an emergency department immediately, so make sure to call as soon as you start to develop symptoms. Step 2 is very important, so listen closely. Epinephrine is the most life-saving treatment for anaphylaxis. There are other medications that ER doctors will give you once you arrive at the hospital, but nothing is as effective as epinephrine. So if you're out in public and you don't have an EpiPen with you, call out for one. Even if it takes every ounce of energy you have, I want you to scream out, "Does anyone have an EpiPen?" Someone close by may have one on hand, and that EpiPen is the only thing separating you from life and death. So make sure to utilize your surroundings. If you're enjoying this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below. This is how you use an EpiPen. 1. Take the EpiPen out of its case. 2. Hold the EpiPen firmly and remove the blue cap. 3. Press the orange part firmly against the mid-outer thigh. 4. You will hear a click. Hold the EpiPen against the thigh for 10 seconds. In the scenario I mentioned at the beginning of this video, it's pretty obvious that we're dealing with anaphylaxis because I mentioned that your throat is closing up. But anaphylaxis isn't always so straightforward and doesn't always happen so quickly. Sometimes it can take over an hour to feel the full effect of your airway narrowing. Anaphylaxis affects more than one part of the body at the same time. It's important to know some of the other ways that anaphylaxis can present so you don't delay treatment, which will ultimately save your life. The following symptoms are commonly seen in anaphylaxis: swelling. As I mentioned before, anaphylaxis can cause your throat to close up. This is because anaphylaxis causes swelling of the airways. This swelling can occur in the back of your throat, making it difficult to breathe and swallow, but can also involve your tongue, lips, and other parts of your face. Respiratory symptoms. Respiratory symptoms may include shortness of breath, wheezing, or stridor, which is a high-pitched sound and is heard when air tries to pass through a narrow airway. Skin changes. Another common symptom of anaphylaxis is hives, which are raised, itchy bumps on the skin. You may also see changes in the color of your skin, such as flushing or loss of color, causing you to appear pale. Abdominal pain, vomiting, and diarrhea. Not many people know these symptoms of anaphylaxis, but they're important to recognize. Anaphylaxis doesn't just cause swelling of the throat. It causes swelling of other mucous membranes, including the intestines. This can result in severe abdominal pain, vomiting, and diarrhea. And lastly, shock. No, we're not talking about surprises here. Shock in the medical sense means hypotension or low blood pressure. A normal blood pressure is around 120 over 80. If your blood pressure drops below 90 over 60, this is considered low. You can also get a weak and rapid pulse. When your blood pressure drops dangerously low, this can cause you to become lightheaded and pass out because you don't have enough blood circulating to your brain. So now you've recognized that you're experiencing anaphylaxis and you've called 911. The ambulance arrives and you're off to the hospital. What happens next? Congratulations, you get to meet me. If you haven't already received epinephrine, the ambulance crew will likely give it to you on the way to the hospital. The effect is usually pretty rapid, and most people will start to have an easier time breathing soon after receiving epinephrine. Once you arrive at the emergency department, you will receive several other medications, including steroids, Benadryl, fluids, and an antihistamine through an IV. The funny thing about anaphylaxis is that sometimes the symptoms resolve completely after receiving medication, but sometimes they return. For that reason, you will likely be observed in the emergency department for several hours to make sure that your symptoms are gone for good. If your symptoms return, you will receive more epinephrine and you will likely be admitted to the hospital for observation. If your symptoms have completely resolved after a period of observation in the emergency department, you will be discharged with a short course of steroids and an EpiPen, which you should always carry with you just in case you ever experience another anaphylactic reaction. If you've had an anaphylactic reaction in the past, you have an increased risk of developing it again. Other people with increased risk are those who have asthma and allergies. If you have these other risk factors, it's important to find ways to control them. That's why I suggest you check out this next video where I discuss tips on how to successfully manage your allergies, including how to control hay fever, as well as other common allergens such as pet dander and mold. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. To learn more interesting facts about emergency medicine, subscribe to the channel. Here are two more videos that you should check out to learn more about your health.